At the end of the accounting period, the merchandiser would prepare the income statement and balance sheet. Here you have illustration to show how you prepare income statement and balance sheet from adjusted trial balance. Given this adjusted trial balance, it includes all the items to be used in preparing the income statement and the balance sheet. This will be your given exercise. Then, for the solution, you are required to prepare income statement and balance sheet. For the income statement, you need to start with sales revenues. For a merchandiser, the most important source of revenue is from selling the goods. You start by sales revenue and subtract from the sales revenue all the sales returns and the sales discounts that happen during the accounting period. All these are given to you in the adjusted trial balance. You just prepare income statement by starting with sales revenue minus sales return, and you know in accounting we use a bracket for subtraction. That's why the 2000 is put between brackets. So sales revenue minus sales return minus sales discount, you get net sales. From this net sales, you need to subtract the cost of goods sold. So you reach the gross profit. That's the profit from selling the goods. But not yet net profit. To reach the net profit, you need to subtract all the other expenses other than the cost of goods. We have other expenses like rent expense, salaries expense, wages expense, advertising expense. All the other expenses must be subtracted from the gross profit in order to reach the net profit. And by reaching the net profit, you finished the income statement. Then you are required to prepare the balance sheet. The balance sheet has two sides. In one side, we have the assets. In the other side, we have the liabilities and owner's equity. In the assets, we start by the current assets and then the fixed assets. First, in the current assets, we have the cash. You just copy the cash from the given adjusted trial balance. After the cash, we have the accounts receivable. And for the accounts receivable, you need to understand the allowance for uncollectible account. It will be our topic later on. We'll have a chapter about allowance for uncollectible account later on. But at this point, I just need you to understand that allowance for uncollectible account is amount estimated that may be not be able to collect it. You know, accounts receivable means what? Means accounts to be received, money to be received. If I doubt that some of the receivables will not be able to be collected, my doubt is translated into allowance for uncollectible account. This allowance estimated amount of accounts receivable that may not be received. That's why this amount is subtracted from the accounts receivable to reach the net accounts receivable. So accounts receivable minus allowance for uncollectible accounts gives net accounts receivable. Then we have to put the ending inventory as one of the current assets. The total of cash plus net accounts receivable plus ending inventory gives us the total current assets. Then we go to the fixed assets. We have land, equipment, and you notice that accumulated depreciation of the equipment is subtracted from the value of the equipment. Fixed assets are used for a long period of time, many periods of times, many years. That's why we need to depreciate the fixed asset all over its years of usage. And all the depreciation calculated for the fixed asset during its whole previous life is added up into an account of accumulated depreciation. This accumulated depreciation amount is subtracted from the value of the asset in the balance sheet. You find equipment by its value, subtracted from it the accumulated depreciation, and all these values are given to you in the adjusted trial balance in the given exercise. You notice that for land there is no depreciation because land is the only fixed asset which is not depreciated. Then we add the fixed assets and the current assets. We get the total assets. In the other side of the balance sheet, we have the liabilities and owner's equity. We start by the liabilities. We have the loans, the notes payable, the accounts payable. Then we have the total liabilities. Then for the owner's equity, we have the capital minus withdrawals plus net profit. We get the net profit from the income statement that we prepared. If we look at the income statement that we prepared, you'll find that we have the net profit from the income statement. Then we reach the total owner's equity. At the end, total liabilities plus total owner's equity must be equal to total assets.